is the difference between Autotelic the first time you met Radio Republic and Autotelic today?
I think we kind of know who we are a little more, a little better now. Like, we're a little more specific with what we want the sound like, or what we want our sound to be with this album. And I think, what
else? Saka ano din, nag-grow na din yung tiwala ko with Radio Republic kasi nung first na lumabas kami. Nandun na yung Radio Republic. Tapos, si Akeli, nandun na sila, Zach. Diba? Tapos, hanggang sa mga gigs na subaybayan nila yung growth namin. Eh.
Yeah.
Tapos nakita nila na nag-change ng lineup, dumating si Kai, dumating si EJ, hanggang ngayon.
And it's always been a lot of pressure coming from Radio Rep because you guys speak so highly of us and it's so scary.
Yun din. Ang laki din ng pressure kasi...
Guys.
But then it helped us to sort of... It challenged us to kind of deserve that the things you say about us.
So, part na rin na on how we work din. Inisip namin na, guys, huwag natin di-disappoint yung ano, like yung mga namitiwala sa atin, yeah. Radio Rep ganyan.
So I guess it's a confidence thing rin from the last time you saw us.
Kaya siguro safe to say din na from the first time na nag-radio rep kami, lalo ni live performance and everything up to now, sobrang laki ng safe to say na nag-mature yung band, yung chemistry, paano kami magsulat ng mga bagong kanta, mga mag-arrange, so yun.
So this is the first album you guys just started working with MCA.
Yes.
So can you tell us a little bit how that's like? Kasi diba parang dream ng mga indie na parang wow, can I get on the label? And you guys are on one now.
For us, ano siya? Sobrang saya.
Yeah, because we were already working on this album and they came in parang midway. So it was such a big relief for us to have them on board and then to kind of hear people of parang a different world say these things about our songs and sort of invest all this time and effort on getting us out there is kind of a little surreal for our band, but they've been really cool with us and letting us do whatever we want in terms of sound because that's the concern that every band has, like,
okay, so minsan sasabihin ka na uy sanap ka na mag-iiba na kayo ha, yeah. Eh, with MCA naman very transparent din kami with them na sabi din nila, hindi, gawin niya lang siya yung gawin, pero syempre, dapat nagkakaintindihan tayo.
Yeah, but in terms of music making, like, they just let us do whatever you want. So we're coming out, our album is actually in Korean. just kidding. No. We just want to ride that trend. But no. I mean, they just let us do whatever you want in the studio and then...
Tsaka kaya ano rin eh, hindi kami nahirapan in terms of transition, in terms of being an independent to a signed artist. Kasi yun na nga eh, parang technically parang walang nagbago. Kasi yun nga, parang...
Yung mindset
ba? Oo. Tsaka parang hinayaan nila kami in terms of creative control. Na pati yung mga parang hindi nila pinapakailaman in terms of ano yung image namin, yung mga stigma or stereotype sa mga being a label artist na dapat may abs, dapat... Mahirapan ako dun eh, kaya ako talaga yung apektado. pero gets, parang kaya sa amin parang... Para paminsan, sigurado ba tayo label na tayo? Or under a label na tayo? Pero parang...
Alam mo yun? Factor din siguro na nag-start ng tele...
Na walang abs.
Hanggang ngayon wala.
Nag-start Telic kasi as a pop alternative band. Like yung songwriting namin. Ganun na talaga kami. Hindi naman kami nag-start na, kailangan yung mga kanta natin, magigits ka agad. It came out naturally. Tapos hanggang sa, hanggang sa nag-develop kami, hanggang sa nag-develop yung creative process namin. Yun pa rin lumalabas. Talagang straightforward.
So, happy kami being with MCA na. Tapos, parang sobrang okay. Yun.
Okay, mamam ko yung joke.
Hindi sip-sip to.
Hi, we're Autotelic and you're watching Radio Republic.